the phenomena of absentee landlordism. Permanent landlord settlement was introduced in 1793 during the time of Cornwallis. 1793 during the time of Cornwallis. By this settlement, the land only was fixed in perpetuity. And the land only was fixed very high. Arbitrarily fixed very high. And the permanent land owner settlement was introduced in Bengal initially. Later it was extended to Assam, Orissa, etc. Later. Sir, one important negative consequence of the permanent land owner settlement is the emergence of absentee landlordism. It is one of the negative aspects of the permanent land owner settlement is the emergence of absentee landlordism. What is this absentee landlordism? See, according to the permanent landowner settlement, the land was given to a jamindar. Jamindar was made the owner of the land, and he was supposed to give the land revenue, which is already fixed by the British, on a predetermined date before the sunset. This is called the sunset law. On a predetermined date before the sunset, which is called a sunset law. Supposing if a jamindar doesn't give the prescribed land revenue before the sunset of the particular day, then the land would be auctioned. Sir, what is the problem here? The problem here is in the initial years of the permanent land revenue settlement, none of the jamindars could pay the land revenue on time because most of the jamindars were traditional jamindars. They could not pay the land revenue on time. So most of the jamindars, from them the land was taken and it was auctioned. Sir, who bought the land? A new group of people bought the land. They happens to be moneylenders. Historians are telling moneylenders converted themselves into jamindars. Significant. This is a significant phenomena. Conversion of moneylenders into jamindars, landowning community. Historians say that the moneylenders should not be blamed. Why? Because the avenues for them to invest the money in the industrialization or industries is absent because of the colonial rule. Otherwise, moneylender would have become a capitalist. That is what happened in the Western countries. You understand? And these moneylenders had huge money. They are always waiting for an opportunity to multiply this money. And they cannot invest in the industries because the industrial revolution was not present in India. So their only option left open was to invest that money in the land. That is why moneylenders had converted into jamindar. Sir, this is good. Good. But it has got a problem. The problem is the moneylender doesn't know anything about agriculture. He knows nothing about peasantry. So what happens? He is just bothered about collection of the land revenue. That's it. He doesn't understand about the problems of the peasants. And this moneylender, he refuses to stay himself in the village because he doesn't know anything about the village and he has no need to stay in the village. So he is staying in an urban center. Just coming to the villages to collect the land revenue. He is absent from the land. He is a landlord, absent from the land. That is why we are calling him an absentee landlord. What is his function? To suck the blood of the peasants from the urban centers. The jamindars become distant sucking pumps, sucking the wealth of the rural areas and spending in the urban centers. So absentee landlordism is one of the greatest negative consequences of the permanent landowner settlement. Later, this phenomenon of absentee landlordism, you may say the phenomenon of absentee landlordism further led to the phenomenon of what is called as sub-infuduation. Sub-infuduation, which means emergence of intermediaries between the peasant and the British.